Thank you. Fisher.
Expect me to believe that the prospect of absolute power holds no temptation for you.
Hold it right there, bloodsucker!
Makes you look awfully petty.
Oh,
Looks like you're having a real swell time here. But you've had your fun. I'm taking Alwyn back.
You speak as though you have the power to stop me. My niece shall be reborn as a dark queen and rule this world.
Say what?
You mean my princess is going to...
Ragna, listen. Inside this golden egg is the power of Demon Lord Lucian. My uncle plans to embed it inside me. And once reborn, the Demon Lord will go on to conquer the world.
In truth, I had intended to become an emperor myself. Unfortunately, this power seems as though it would only recognize a female host. And besides me, who would make a worthier vessel than my demons?
You selfish son of a... Why would you even want to be a demon lord anyway?
My ultimate purpose has always been to reclaim the pride of demonkind. Whether my niece is the one who brings this dream to fruition matters not to me, so long as it is done. And I am certain that my brother is smiling upon our endeavor from the netherworld as well.
I refuse! My father went to a lot of trouble to steal this power away. You have some nerve. What makes you so sure he'd approve of what you're doing?
Such a cloying display of sentimentality. It changes nothing, however. Let us continue, shall we? I find myself wondering how long you'll hold out before giving in to the call.
Enough of your crap! I'm just a pilot, so I can't exactly say I'm familiar with demons and monsters and fairies and all that stuff. But I know there are good ones out there. People I can trust, like Alwyn and Rue. I've met some annoying ones too, like that stupid cat. Even cross paths with some that amaze me, like Diamond. What I eventually realized is that they're not all that different from humans, really.
Your point being?
Being a demon doesn't make someone bad any more than being a human makes them good. So get off your damn high horse, because I'm sick to death of hearing you drone on and on. I'm gonna try to change your mind. And if you want to just step down and pass on your dream to Alwyn, you can do that. Not be a bad idea. But the moment you decided to force her into your scheme, this became more about your self-satisfaction than your dream. Your ego may be puffed up like a balloon, but that doesn't mean Alwyn has to come along for the ride.
Ragna.
So, the little gnat fancies himself a sage now. But I'm afraid your words carry little weight without the power to back them up. Come, and I shall crush you. Even without Alwyn's support, you still seem to find it in you to bark away. Very well, human. If my attention is what you wished, you shall have it. I shan't overlook you this time. And after I have beaten you to within an inch of your life, I shall drain you of every last drop. You can try.
You're wrong, though. And I'm going to make sure you come out of this knowing why. Bring it on, Zahar Dumumbria!
Significant human! Look, I won't forgive you! Oh, wait!
Is where the real fight begins.
To think I had to take this form to deal with the likes of you. Just like when I fought my brother. Power you all!
Holy Ray!
Greetings and salutations. I believe we reached the climax of this little scene.
Myrmidon! Why? Why are you doing this?
It's not that I'm not grateful for everything you've done. But I think it's high time you exited the stage. Trust his remaining magic to the princess. Stubborn and defiant to the last. You can think of it as a family keepsake from the good Marquis. Do take care of it now, won't you?
Uncle.
Damn. Who the hell do you think you are? Just popping in out of nowhere and doing whatever you feel like. What's your game, Thermidor?
My game, if you would call it such, is going splendidly. At long last, my preparations are finally complete.
Preparations for what?
For the coming of my true master, whose power lies sleeping within this egg, ready to burst forth.
Power of the Gilded One.
Now, Mia, do be a deer and come out.
What?
Time is at hand. Accept your fate.
I accept, Thermidor.
Hey! Stop it! Mia, what are you doing?
Exactly as you suspect, Princess. Mia is the one who has inherited the soul of the Demon Lord. It is her destiny to be born anew as Lucien the Gilded.
Huh?
Just as I thought. It's true, Raven. I remember. All the memories. It feels like so long ago. Those terrible things I did to everyone.
Mia.
I remember what happened 7 years ago. That day you went to town with your friends. The day when Thermidor came to visit me. understand now? Mom and Dad died? Who the enemy you've hated all these years really is?
Leo.
Thermidor. He took me away. As I cried and screamed, he rescued me from our house as it went up in flames. And ever since then, he's taken care of me.
Why didn't you tell me? I'm your brother, damn it! You could have at least said something!
I didn't know how! I just knew that I never wanted you to know who I really was, the terrible things I've done. There was no way I could tell you!
Stop it, Mia.
Don't be so hasty.
Day of your return. I have gone before you and prepared your throne for your arrival.
Excellent. Let us make our way there at once.
By your command.
Wait! Stop!
Farewell.
Later. If there's no trouble there, I'd like you to hurry back as soon as you can. We have an unexpected situation on our hands here.
What now?
What do you mean by that?
I can feel something in the skies, like the air itself is quaking. And besides that, our magical reserves have just about reached their limits. Either way, we need you back here at once.
Very well. Ragna?
Yeah. This ain't the time or the place to space out. Let's grab Odessa and get back there. The sooner I've got my feet back on Grand Fallon, the better.
Thank you. Thank you.